Hello friends, welcome to a new series of the channel Quest for Knowledge, that is Reasoning and Aptitude series. We are starting this series because reasoning and aptitude have become indifferential parts of all government exams these days. Here, our motive is to make you understand the concepts in the easiest way possible. So, without wasting any time, let's start the video. But before that, subscribe the channel. Thank you. So friends, I am back with the last part of my topic, clocks. I hope you have watched the previous two parts and your concepts are clear till now. So without wasting time, let's move forward. So in our previous video, we have studied about how many times a day the hands are straight. They are straight when they are coinciding, that is, they are making an angle of 0 degree, and that happens 22 times a day. And they are again straight when they are opposite to each other and make an angle of 180 degree. So this again happens 22 times a day, and in last we concluded that in total they are straight 44 times a day. Now we have to read about how many times they are at right angles in a day or in a particular hour, that is when they are making an angle of 90 degree. So there is a direct question asked in the exams, and it is a very important question, that how many times does the hands of the clock are at right angles in a day. So in 1 hour they are at right angles twice. So if they are 2 times at right angles in 1 hour, that it means that they may be at right angles 24 times in 12 hours. But this is not the case. They are 22 times right angles in 12 hours. Why so? Because between 2 o'clock, 2 o'clock to 4 o'clock, they are at right angles 3 times. Similarly, from 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock, they are at right angles 3 times. So in 12 hours, they are at right angles 22 times. And in entire day, they are at right angles 44 times. Now, with the help of some questions, we will understand why this is happening. So first of all, let's see, between 12 and 1 o'clock. So we know that every hour there will be 2 points when they will be at right angles. So first of all, we will consider the time gap between the two hands of the clock at the starting position. So like my time limit is starting from 12 o'clock, so at 12 o'clock the hands are 0 minutes apart. They both are coinciding, so the difference between the both are 0 minutes. So what I will be doing, I will be adding 15 and 45 to the time difference. Why am I adding 15 and 45? Because the hour hand will remain at 12 and the minute hand will start moving. So they will be at right angle once it will cross at 15 minutes time, and again at 30 minutes they will be straight, and after 45 minutes they will be again at 90 degree. So I will be adding, for first point I will be adding 15 to 0 and then 45 to 0. The multiplicative factor we derived in our last video, that is 12 upon 11, will remain the same. Here this thing will change according to our starting time. So here, because the time gap is 0 minutes, so I am adding 15 in it. 0 plus 15 is 15. After solving it, it comes out that after 16, 4 upon 11 minutes past 12 o'clock, they will be at right angles. Similarly, for second point, I have added 45 into 0. So multiplying 12 upon 11 into 45, I get 49 1 upon 11 minutes past 12 o'clock. So these are the 2 points when the hands of the clock will be at right angles between 12 o'clock and 1 o'clock. Now let's move forward to 1 o'clock and 2 o'clock. Now when it is 1 o'clock, both the hands are 5 minutes apart. So what I will do, I will be adding 15 to 5 and then 45 to 5. So now this addition or subtraction will be depending upon the time gap between the hands of the clock when the when our time limit is starting. Okay, so now the which cases I am considering here, the time gap is already lesser than 15 minutes. That's why I am adding 15 as well as 45. So you have to remember this thing, that when time limit is less than 15 minutes, that is 0, 5 or 10 minutes, what we have to do, we have to add the 15 and add 45 into the time gap between the two hands. Here the time gap is 5 minutes, so I have added 5 plus 15, and for the second point 5 plus 45, 12 upon 11 will remain the same. So after solving these, I get 2 points, 21, 9 upon 11 minutes past 1 o'clock, and then 54, 6 upon 11 minutes past 1 o'clock. Let's move forward. Between 2 and 3 o'clock. Now here what happens, the time gap is 10 minutes. So again, as I did earlier, I will be adding 15 as well as 45 for the 2 points. So first point I will be getting at 27 3 upon 11 minutes past 2 o'clock. Now let's move on to the second point. When I add 10 plus 45, it becomes 55, and the answer is 60 minutes past 2 o'clock. So 60 minutes past 2 o'clock will become 3 o'clock itself. So between 2 and 3, 1 points come at 27 3 upon 11 minutes, whereas the other points come exactly at 3 o'clock. So now our next hour limit is 3 to 4. Now here they are 15 minutes apart. They are already 15 minutes apart now. Now if I will be adding 45 in it, so time gap, so it the total will be 60. So but we have to remain between a time gap of 1 hour. Okay, we have to be with 3 and 4 o'clock. So if it is already 60, after multiplying it with a fraction which is greater than 1, the time gap will increase from 1 hour. So we will cross the limit of 4 o'clock. So we will not be adding 45 from now. Now we will what we will be doing, we will be adding 15 as well as subtracting 15. You have to remember these things. When time gap is less than 15 minutes, we will be adding 15 and 45. When time gap is 15 or greater than 15, then add 15 and subtract 15, because by adding 45, we will cross the time gap of 1 hour. So here when I add 15, it comes out to be 32 8 upon 11 minutes past 3 o'clock. But when I subtract 15, so it comes out to be 0 minutes past 3 o'clock, which is 3 o'clock itself. So between 2 to 4, they are meeting only thrice. Once, 27 3 upon 11 minutes past 2 o'clock, and 32 8 upon 11 minutes past 3 o'clock. And one time is the common time, that is 3 o'clock. So here we conclude why from 2 o'clock to 4 o'clock they are meeting 3 times. So now let's see forward. Next, the time limit is for 4 o'clock and 5 o'clock. Now what happens between when the time is 4 o'clock, the time gap between the two hands of clock is 20 minutes apart. I have already told you that when time gap is 15 or more than 15 minutes, what we have to do, we have to add 15 as well as subtract 15. So I will get 2 points by subtracting 15 and adding 15. So the answer will be 5 upon 11 minutes, and 38 2 upon 11 minutes past 4 o'clock. So similarly, we can do for the time range 5 to 6, 6 to 7 and 7 to 8. You will be subtracting as well as adding 15 from the time gap between the two hands of clock. Now let's move on to the time between 8 to 9 o'clock. Now what happens? They are 40 minutes apart. So I will be again subtracting 15 and adding 15 for the 2 points. When I will subtract 15, द टाइम विल 27 3/11 मिनट्स पास्ट 8 o'clock. सो दे विल बी एट राइट एंगल्स एट 27 3/11 मिनट्स पास्ट 8 o'clock. वेयर एज वेन आई एम एडिंग 15 अगेन द टाइम गैप कम्स 60 मिनट्स पास्ट 8 o'clock, विच इज 9 o'clock. इट मीन्स फ्रॉम 8 to 9, once they are at right angles at 27 3/11, and secondly they are at right angles when it is 9 o'clock. So now let's move on to 9 o'clock. From 9 to 10, now they are 45 minutes. Now here again our addition and subtraction factor will change, because now they are 45 minutes apart. So now if I will be adding 15, again the time gap will be 60 minutes. By and multiplying it with fraction greater than 1, they will cross the time limit of 1 hour. So we have to change our factors here. Now we will be subtracting 15 and as well as subtracting 45. Okay, so where the time gap is 45 or more than 45, now both subtractions will be there. And once we will be subtracting 15, and second time we will be subtracting 45. So when I subtract 15 from 45, the time is 32 8/11 minutes past 9 o'clock, whereas on subtracting 45, it's 0 minutes past 9 o'clock, which is again 9 o'clock. Here comes the point that they are at right angles 3 times from 2 to 4, and they are at right angles 3 times from 8 to 10 o'clock. So instead of at right angles 24 times in 12 hours, they are at right angles 22 times in 12 hours. So now let's see, from 10 o'clock to 11 o'clock, now they are 50 minutes apart. So now we will be subtracting 15 and 45 from the time gap. So by subtracting 15, we get 38 2/11 minutes, and by subtracting 45, I get 5 5/11 minutes past 10 o'clock, when the hands will be at right angles. So from here we conclude that they are at right angles 22 times in 12 hours. So they will be at right angles 44 times in 24 hours. So for getting the particular times when they are at right angles, you have to keep in mind, because there are three sets of hours. Once when the time gap is less than 15 minutes, then the time gap is from 15 to 45 minutes. So from 15 to 45, we will be subtracting 15 and adding 15. And when the time gap reaches to 45 or greater than 45, then we have to subtract 15 and subtract 45, whereas our 12 upon 11 will remain the same. So now we will see one or two more questions related to clocks. So this is a question. It is saying that clock is set right at 5 a.m. The clock loses 16 minutes in 24 hours. So what will be the true time when the clock indicates 10 p.m. on the fourth day? So suppose today is some Monday or Sunday. So after fourth day at 10 p.m., first of all, we have to calculate the total time spent between these times, from 5 a.m. today till 10 p.m. on the fourth day. So how much time has been spent? 89 hours has been spent. So what it is saying? It is saying that clock is losing 16 minutes 20 in 24 hours. So if it is losing 16 minutes in 24 hours, it means it's having 23 hours and 44 minutes, whereas the correct clock will be showing 24 hours. So these 23 hours and 44 minutes are to be converted into hours. How we will convert? We will be dividing this 44 minutes with 60. So it will be converted into hours, then changing into mixed fraction and adding. It is 356/15 hours. So what does it say? That 356/15 hours of this clock, about which it is being talked in the question, it is equal to the 24 hours of any correct clock. But how many hours it has spent? It has spent 89 hours. So by using unitary method, 89 hours, we will be getting 24 multiply 15 upon 356 multiply 89, which is equal to 90 hours of the correct clock. So it means if this clock has spent 89 hours, the correct clock must have spent 90 hours. So it means if it is showing 10 p.m., it must have shown the correct time must be 11 p.m. So let's move on to the next question. It is saying that a watch which gains uniformly is 2 minutes low at noon on Monday. Means it is losing 2 minutes at 12 p.m. on Monday and 4 minutes 48 seconds fast at 2 p.m. on the following Monday. Means after 1 week, when it is 2 p.m. on Monday, it has gained 4 minutes and 48 seconds. So we have to check in between this 1 week period when this watch was correct. It's an important question. So first of all, we will be calculating the total time spent between the two time limits we have given. So from 12 p.m. Monday to 2 p.m. on the following Monday, how much time has been spent? 7 days and 2 hours. So I will be changing it into hours. So 1 day contains 24 hours. So 7 days will contain 168 plus 2 hours extra. So total time spent is 170 hours. So first of all, we have to convert the time range into hours. From days, convert into hours. Then let's see what's happening. First of all, when it's 12 p.m., it's losing 2 minutes. I will be depicting it with minus sign because it's losing something. And after 1 week at 2 p.m., it's gaining something. So the gain is depicted with plus sign. So let me change it into minutes. So after changing it into minutes, it comes 24 upon 5 minutes. Now the difference between the two. The total time gained by the watch is 24 upon 5 minus 2. Because first of all, it has gained these 2 minutes. Then again, it has gained this much time. So that's why it is gaining this time. So the difference comes out to be 34 upon 5 minutes. So clock has gained 34 upon 5 minutes. But to show the correct time, it has to only gain only 2 minutes. It has gained this much time, but to show the correct time, it has to gain only 2 minutes, then it will be correct. So again, applying unitary method, 34 upon 5 minutes are gained in 170 hours. So 1 minute is gained in 170 into 5 upon 34 hours. So as I have told you already, that to be correct, it has to gain 2 minutes. So 2 minutes will be gained in 170 into 5 upon 34 multiply 2, which is equal to 50 hours. Now let's convert these 50 hours into days. So 50 hours are equal to 2 days and 2 hours. From Monday, 2 days are on Wednesday and 2 hours. We started on 12 p.m. and from 12 p.m. 2 hours forward are 2 p.m. Wednesday. So within this week, the clock was correct at 2 p.m. Wednesday. If you have liked the video and understood the concept and liked the content, then kindly like and share this video and subscribe the channel. Thank you.